Don't ever assume that this is what it's all about. There's only a few people that have an opportunity to do what you guys are doing, right? Take advantage of it, right? Come on, let's go.
Let's run.
Run.
Georgetown, the oldest Catholic university in the country, has long been among the leading national institutions of higher education. Together with classmates from every state and more than 100 foreign countries, students reside in a community that extends from the quaint historic village of Georgetown, with its flavor of a small college town, to the heart of Washington, with many of the nation's most important museums, libraries, archives, and cultural institutions. Students are able to take advantage of the many activities on campus, as well as the fascinating opportunities that Washington has to offer. Georgetown University has rich historical roots that intertwine with those of our nation itself. The center of the Georgetown seal, the American Eagle, expresses the university's allegiance to the republic it was founded to serve. These two great ideals, American democracy and imaginative education, began together in 1789 in the city of Washington, D.C., and have thrived, creating a community united by common values and a shared sense of purpose. The Georgetown University men's lacrosse team exemplifies these qualities, emphasizing the values of persistence, pride, and hard work to achieve a team sense of purpose, to count themselves among the top lacrosse programs in the country. The Hoyas completed an outstanding season in 2002, posting a 12-3 record, finishing fourth in the final USILA coaches poll while earning a sixth consecutive trip to the NCAA championship tournament. Heart-stopping one-goal losses to NCAA champion Syracuse University during the regular season and NCAA runner-up Princeton University in the quarterfinals further entrenched the Hoyas among the elite collegiate lacrosse programs and strengthened their resolve to earn the opportunity to play on Memorial Day. Ranked as high as third during the regular season, the 2002 Hoyas were directed from the sidelines by Hall of Fame head coach Dave Urich, who presently ranks third in winning percentage and fourth in career wins among active Division I coaches. Former Hoya All-Americans Matt Rienzo and Scott Urich coordinated the defense and offense respectively, and Big J. Kenny coordinated the substitution box and worked closely with the face-off specialist.
Make sure to play a good team defense, understand? Play together, play hard, play together. Good luck, sir. Good luck.
Offensively, the 2002 Hoyas featured balanced scoring with six players tallying 20 or more points. Two-time ECAC Offensive Player of the Year, Steve Dussault, led the way with a record-setting 53 goals and 16 assists for 69 points. A first-time All-American attackman and twice elected as Tewaratan Trophy finalist, Steve punctuated his outstanding senior season by competing on the 2002 USA lacrosse team that successfully defended their world championship in Perth, Australia this summer. An academic All-American, North-South All-Star Game participant, and Warrior Inside Lacrosse National Player of the Year, Steve finished the year second in the nation in goals per game and third nationally in points per game. A repeat selection as ECAC Offensive Player of the Year, Dussault's outstanding career on the Hilltop was further recognized by receiving the 2002 Lieutenant Raymond Enners Player of the Year Award, as well as the Robert A. Duffy Scholar Athlete Award. Attackmen Neil Goldman and Mike Hammer, along with midfielders Trevor Walker, Waleed Hodge, and Phil Vincente, round out the 20-point scorers for the 2002 Hoyas. Sophomore attackman Neil Goldman had a breakout season totaling 44 points on 16 goals and a team high of 28 assists. Fourth on the team in ground balls, Neil epitomized the hard-riding, all-out hustling style of play that has become a trademark of Hoya attackmen. Junior attackman Mike Hammer found the back of the net for 26 goals, handed out 17 assists, and played the entire season with a commitment to excellence and a contagious passion to win. Mike ranked 7th in the ECAC in scoring and was named 2nd team All-League. Bigger, faster, and stronger, junior midfielder Trevor Walker was a coach's dream in 2002. Equally effective at both ends of the field, Trevor scored 25 goals, including a 4-goal effort in the NCAA quarterfinal matchup against Princeton. An honorable mention All-American and first-team All-ECAC performer, the big lefty has worked hard to earn the right to be considered one of the best midfielders in the country. Expectation levels and player roles can change significantly from one year to the next, and sophomore midfielder Waleed Hodge is a classic example. Playing primarily in a defensive role last year, Waleed worked his way into the regular rotation this year, scoring 15 goals, and was one of the more consistent Hoya midfielders. Veteran midfielder Phil Vincente stepped up in 2002, ripping the nets for 13 goals while providing a daunting physical presence. The big guy reaped the benefits of his persistence and hard work and took full advantage when the opportunity to contribute presented itself. Attackman Doug Staub rounds out the double-digit scorers for the 2002 Hoyas with 16 points on 10 goals and 6 assists. The senior attackman also contributed a number of big hits as well as key ground balls off the ride. Depth at the midfield has always been a Georgetown trademark, and the 2002 Hoyas were certainly no exception. Sophomore Mike Boynton, freshman Bryce Queener and Dave Palisso, and junior Mike Zuckerman played key roles throughout the season, gained valuable experience, and will be counted on to step up and expand their contributions in the future. Short stick defensive midfield is a key specialized position in college lacrosse, and the Hoyas have three of the best in Doug Muller, P.J. Polisso, and Mike Chiara. Strength, speed, and quickness, along with physical and mental tenacity, are the trademark of this trio of junior midfielders. Polisso and Muller were also part of the man-down defense unit, while Mike Chiara provided depth and experience at the face-off X. Senior midfielder Mike Canick and rookie Andy Corno teamed up to handle the critical face-off duties for the Hoyas, winning over 55% of their draws. Co-captain and recipient of the Prof. Decker Unsung Hero Award, Mike Canick sacrificed precious playing time to keep himself primed for the crucial face-off effort battles. An ECAC and USILA Academic All-American, Canick finished third on the team in the ball hawk race with 64 ground balls. Freshman Andy Corno collected 67 ground balls while winning 57% of his face-off attempts. The tenacious Georgetown defense was most effective in 2002, yielding just over 8 goals per game. Led by All-American and two-time All-Conference goalie Scott Schroeder, the formidable Hoya D played with controlled aggression, pride, and unity. A three-year starter in goal, Scott was an ECAC Player of the Week, as well as a participant in the North-South All-Star Game. Selected as co-MVP of the 2002 Hoyas, along with teammate Steve Dussault, Scott was a difference maker between the pipes. Honorable mention All-American and first-team All-Conference Brent Gresham once again provided the Hoya D with matchup versatility and effectiveness. Twice elected to the ECAC All-Academic Team, Gresh consistently rose to the challenge to stop the opponent's top gun. The combined efforts of senior co-captain Mike Harney, junior Pat Collins, sophomore Andy Brazil, and freshman Brody Merrill provided an intimidating physical presence to the Hoya D that definitely left a lasting impression on the opposition. Veteran Kyle Sweeney elevated his game to a new level in 2002 and redefined the position of long stick midfielder. A repeat All-League selection as well as ECAC Defensive Player of the Year, Kyle led the Hoyas in ground balls with 75, tallied 5 goals and 4 assists, and played with intimidating and instinctive field sense. Kyle's impressive season did not go unnoticed as he was selected First Team All-American, the first Hoya defender to earn the First Team All-American honors.
simple game. Get after the ball when it's on the ground and move your feet. Play hard. Let's go. Bring it up.
The success of the 2002 Georgetown lacrosse team will be a source of pride for years to come. The six seniors leave the Hilltop with a legacy of persistence, pride, and hard work. A four-year record of 48 wins, 12 losses, four consecutive NCAA tournament appearances, the highest USILA ranking in Hoya history, a home record of 24 wins and 3 losses, and memories to last a lifetime. The coaching staff is extremely proud of these young men for their talent and success, the heights obtained, as well as the obstacles overcome, but more importantly, for their character. Lacrosse tradition on the Hilltop has been enhanced by their commitment to excellence. Hoya Saxa.
You got to generate your own intensity, right?
Hey, boys.
Every day is a good day to play, right? Some days are better than others, but this is a good day.
Brooklyn. Yeah.
In a dash, hold two heaters, block out, put holes through beaters, ghetto fast, throw through cheaters, ballin', Brooklyn Dawn, addicted to Chris, hook them dawn, 50 G's, hook a song, ma, I wanna see how you look in thongs, hustlin', guys are simpos, cause I chop rocks the size of Mentos, blame me, I tried to hint, look at the hurt, your eyes are squint closed, pimpin', here's a new way to flirt, I listen to the two way you learn, it goes, let's go, VIP, boo, raise your skirt. Holla back, youngin. Holla back. 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 I'm gangster. Y'all just wanna be federal agents on a piece. 30 a gram, 28 on the keys. Got a good lawyer. I'm